Hey guys, welcome back to my Jack and Daxter walkthrough part 14. And sorry if I forget the number of the walkthrough, but I think this is part 14 because I moved all my parts onto my hard drive, or my external hard drive, so I really don't know what part this is. But hopefully I'm right. But there we go, we got 200 out of 200 precursor orbs in the Precursor Basin. And now we're going to be going over to do the two ring challenges. And also we're going to talk to the geologist. And also that guy that was in the barrel. And the hero. So we're going to be talking to a lot of people in this video. And we're also going to get, I think, 3 or 4 orbs. From all the villagers and stuff. So let me go through these rings. Now remember I was watching, what was his name? ScottishDuck17, he did a walkthrough of this game, I think, 2 years ago, and I was watching it. I think today I was watching it. And congratulations to him, because he has 16,000 subscribers, which is really good. Hopefully I'll hit that mark, probably next year or something. It'd be really awesome. But anyways, let's start Jack and Daxter with these ring challenges now. The first challenge is pretty simple. The blue rings are probably the hardest ones, just because there's one bit on it when you have to go onto a rock and actually jump up onto the rock to get into the ring. It's hard to explain, but I'll show you later. Now let's get this orb, or whatever it's called, power cell. And it's gonna be our 41st power cell. So now let's go back and do the other ring challenge, which is the blue ones. And these ones are a pain in the ass to complete. You'll see why coming up. See, there's the first ring right over there, but we can't get it until we actually go up on this stupid platform up here. Right here, we have to go up and then we have to jump down real carefully. Okay. I know Daxter was talking back there. And the difficult one is coming up right here. The only way you could get it is by going up on this rock. That was really lucky. But yeah, you guys will probably fail if you never played this game. I failed about 6 times. That's how bad I was at this one. But we're gonna go back to the beginning where the... Whoa, crap. I'm gonna have to circle back around. But we're gonna go back to the beginning of the Precursor Basin back there. Now I'm gonna go on this hill. Launch ourselves up there. And sometimes it gets confusing finding where the rings are. All you need to do is just look around and you'll pretty much get it. Whoops, hit that rock. And I was thinking about doing a remake of my Spiral 1 walkthrough. In a few months, like once I hit 300 subscribers, I'll probably do it. And by the way guys, I'm gonna be releasing tons more reviews. I'm gonna try to do a review each week, and this time I'm not lying. I'm actually gonna start making them, because I need to get some more subscribers. I know over the past few days I got about 4 subscribers, which is really good. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Up here. Whoa, almost fell off there. We're almost done with this challenge, guys. And here's the final one right here. Okay, let me go down and get it. And then I'm gonna cut the video right here. Okay, now we're gonna talk to the geologist.
Thank you for saving those moles. That's awfully good of you. Here's a power cell to help you out. Now I can get back to my research.
Okay guys, we're going to get a new power cell now from the geologist since we completed all of our challenges. And in the last video, as you remember, if you guys watched it, we got rid of all those red mole things. We got them back to their homes.
Oh yeah! These orbs to help me win my way back out of this barrel. Here's the power cell, I promise.
Yeah, guys, so basically I cut the video again just because I had to talk to that guy again in order for me to trade the power cells or whatever they're called. Or the precursor orbs. I had to talk to him again, and I didn't want you guys to see that since you already seen in my part 11, I think it was. So now that we talked to that guy, I'm going to go back and do the race, because that's the only way you could actually acquire the race and open it up, is by talking to that guy, which is right here. We go through here. It's a very simple challenge. If you get under 45 seconds on the race, then you'll pretty much win or beat the time, and then you'll get a power cell from that guy in the barrel. Trying to dodge these pistons. And a cool tip here is to hit these smokers and try not to hit those exploding boxes like I did. But yeah, hit those lurkers because they'll launch you up onto different platforms so you can beat your previous time record if you're going for that. But I'm not really going for a new record. I'm just trying to get the damn power cell. But anyways, when we completed it on 42 seconds, I think. Somewhere like that. We're going to be returning to the Precursor Basin anyways later on to get the final scout fly, because I can't find that one. I'll probably just go on YouTube and look it up and try to find where it is. But anyways, let's go and talk to... I think we're going to talk to him now.
Moves, kid. I knew that time record would fall. Now here's your power cell, and I can go collect my big payoff.
Okay guys, now I got this new power cell. I'm going to be talking to the hero of the village, which is crying over to the right. And I'm going to cut the video again just because I had to talk to him again. So here we go. Let's go and trade the 90 orbs to him right now.
Oh, wonderful. You brought me the precursor orbs. All right, I'll fix the bridge. But don't ask me to get involved with that creature again.
Okay guys, so now he's going to move the platforms, and in the next part we're going to be finishing up the Precursor Basin, the Rock Village, and also heading on to the underwater Precursor City. So subscribe guys, and I'll see you later.